Okay, so Webflow has released a new feature called AI Site Builder. And since launching this about 30 minutes ago, I have built 3 production-ready websites. And so in this video, I actually want to do a little bit of a walkthrough of this new AI Site Builder with you so you can kind of get a hang of what it's all about. Okay, so this here is just going to be one take. We're not going to be doing a lot of editing, so forgive me if I ramble. I'm going to go ahead, I'm going to use the AI Site Builder to get started, and then we're going to start off with the first step of it all. So we have to decide if we're building it for a business or a personal project. I'm going to be building this for my brand new web design agency, and I'm going to call this the, let's call it the Hue Sync Web Agency. Now, given what I'm going to be able to do with this feature, the main value proposition of my business is going to be we create production-ready websites in minutes. What else do they recommend here? We are from Canada. And what else? Let's just leave that. I'm not going to dive too much into a prompt here, but we create production. We are an agency from Canada, and we create production-ready websites in minutes. So obviously, you know, we could probably write a better prompt, but this is definitely a good starting point. Okay, step number 3 in this is define your style. So you can see off the bat, you're going to have some styles that you can kind of work with, minimal, futuristic, all that kind of stuff. Now, I'm going to stick with the AI suggested one just so that we can kind of see what it does. But you can already kind of see that, you know, just as you're starting to generate the first version of this, you can actually, customize it quite a bit. Even if you have like a preferred primary color, you could probably just add that straight in here. Okay, so the build process is starting. And so while we wait for this to build, let me quickly share my 2 cents on what I think about Webflow launching an AI site builder. Now, I've talked a little bit about this on Twitter, but here's the thing. Over the last year or so, these AI coding tools have become so much better. So when these tools first came out, it was still quite hard, even with a bit of a coding background, to actually get something up and running. But I think especially over the last 6 months, as more tools have come out, as all of the AI, models have been getting better, it's been getting easier and easier. And the other week I actually tried Lovable for the very first time. And, if you have an understanding of how sites are built and how you kind of use prompting effectively, you can actually do quite a lot with it. Now, the reason why I think that this is significant is because obviously Webflow is a phenomenal tool. When I got my start with Webflow, it really bridged the gap between me not being able to code and me wanting to build websites. And I really tried everything. I tried coding, I tried, websites, that kind of stuff. And Webflow really bridged that gap. But what I think some of these new AI coding tools are doing is they are now creating the next iteration of it. And to be completely honest, I've been kind of waiting for Webflow to create something that really, makes it even easier for someone who is starting at zero to get sites like this up and running. Okay, so now our prompt has turned into a first version of our site. So let's have a little look at what we've got. We've got a few neat little cards. And so, if you were to look at this straight off the bat, my first impression is this is something out of, say, like a template store. So like you could go to, say, the Webflow template store, and you could probably get a site like this. That is my initial impression. But I suppose what we are looking for here is how much we can now customize it before this gets into Webflow. And so the first thing that we can do is we can start customizing our theme, okay? And that is, probably at a high level, kind of where we would start anyway. If we want to generate more themes, we can kind of rotate through them. So let's see what this looks like. And then I suppose the next part of this is going to be, how we can potentially adjust certain parts of our site on the go. So what I can see we can do is we can, first of all, rotate through different layouts, okay? So let's wait for this to happen. And you can kind of see you've it seems like that you'd have like a library of different components for different parts of the site, and it just kind of rotates through them. And so as soon as you have found something that you like, you can kind of, you know, just stick with that particular layout. And so I believe you can do this for most sections. So you would have your classic feature section here where you can kind of see what, you know, your different value propositions will look like. So let's stick with that. I'm not going to dive too much into it. And then there's also the ability to kind of swap styles for the different sections. So with your theme defined, there are obviously a lot of different ways that you can use that theme to create different sections. And so you see that you can even start customizing it straight off the bat here by just clicking through the styles icon over here. And so, you know, just for the first iteration of it, you know, you can start making whatever design changes you want. Now, you can also customize colors. So you can probably rotate through all of the different styles of colors that you want. I'm just going to stick with this one here. I like the look of it. But, you know, this is for a light mode version of the site. But you could probably very quickly also create the dark mode version of the site. So you can just kind of rotate through it. And basically what it will do is it will change what the primary colors are and all that kind of stuff. I will say I'm not much of a designer, so you know, you never know. I might not even know what I'm talking about. But the next part in the customization process will be the heading. So what we can do is the typography. So what we'll be able to do is select fonts. So let's go ahead, let's choose that font here. Now, I'm not exactly sure. So, and this is how you select headings. Where do you select your body tags? Not exactly sure. So let's just stick with headings for now. Maybe this is just headings. I'm not 100% sure. But let's just pick a heading and just stick with it. Here we go. Let's stick with Bebis Night. And it looks like it just basically finds you know, like the body text that kind of complements the heading font. But I'm sure we can change what the actual fonts are later on once we jump into Webflow. Now, sections, we can also customize our sections. Now, this here just kind of looks like the way that it structures the different sections in terms of how the colors are set up. So I suppose just kind of a little bit of a preview of what all of your different section colors look like. So again, kind of good. You get quite a few different options, so accent, subtle, whatever it is, and so you can just kind of click through them, kind of see what the variation is that you like the most. Let's stick with that one. Next, stock images that will be used, so you can rotate through different styles of images, which is quite cool. So let's take the dramatic light one. Obviously, these are just stockholder images for now, but I assume as you, you know, it looks like it actually kind of creates images that are in line with your theme. And these do look like AI images. So maybe it is actually creating custom AI images in the background, which would be quite cool. Okay, so we've got all of this. I'm actually really starting to like the look of this, at least for a first variation of it. Let's keep going. Let's customize our buttons. Okay, so I'm a big fan of just like nice standard buttons. Now, let's go in here, let's make it round. Now, I'm not exactly sure why these buttons are not updating. Oh, it looks like they're updating now, but it still kind of seems to me, let's just switch it to simple. Okay, so you can kind of see, you can kind of rotate through the different button options, and this looks pretty good straight off the bat. Now, let's move on to the next part, which is forms. Now, with your forms, I'm going to keep things simple. We're just going to stick with this, and just to stay consistent with the roundness of our buttons, we'll make sure that our form fields don't have buttons either. Then cards. Now, cards refers to these sections here. Let's also customize that a bit. Let's stick with, I don't know. Let's go ahead, pick something like this to get started. We'll remove the roundness of it. At least I'm trying to. Try here. Okay. Sometimes I think you just need to click through different options in order for it to work. But this is already quite cool. Again, you'll get different variations of it as well. So that's kind of fun. And then I think there's just one more section where you can kind of define, you know, the roundness, which I've kind of already done as I've been building out the different sections. So if you want the roundness to be consistent, I'd suppose that down here is probably the way to do it. Now, obviously goes without saying, but I'll show it anyway. When you're building it in Webflow, it is pretty mobile responsive, even though we might have some little issues here. And yeah. Beta, so you know, things can cause issues, but overall I would say, considering that I've been that this video has been going for 10 minutes, we have kind of built something pretty cool straight off the bat. All right, let's now click on start building. So this is the part where we're gonna take, you know, the first iteration of our site that we've kind of assembled here, and it now gets moved into Webflow. Now here's the thing. If you are someone that is brand new to building websites and you're happy with all of it, maybe you just want to make some changes to the copy, you can just jump in and, you know, change it. I think changing the copy doesn't require much knowledge. So we'll go, we build websites in minutes. And then, honestly, you're pretty much good to hit the publish button. And just like that, within 10 minutes, you've actually built out a site that you can start sharing with clients. Now, there are obviously still going to be parts that you will need to do. You know, you'll have to probably, you know, hook up forms or, you know, do some SEO related things. But if we just look at how long this part of the process typically takes, this is a massive, massive, massive time saver. So another thing that I want to go over. So let's say, for example, that you know, the AI site builder creates our section, but you know, there's just a certain part, there's a certain section on our site that's missing. So what we can do is we can generate a layout. So what we'll do in here is we'll go ahead and we'll start working with our AI assistant. And now we can kind of decide, hey, what kind of content that do we want? And so maybe because this is our web design website, we want to add a gallery section. Now, what happens is out of the box, you get a few different gallery options, you know. So maybe let's stick with this image gallery here. And what will happen is it will just go ahead and it will start generating the section for you. So this part here is, again, will just take a few seconds, and look at that, just like that. It basically takes your already existing design system and it automatically just throws it in here, generates some, you know, nice little AI images for you. And you know, I suppose in a way, these are just placeholders to help you get started. But again, the images that are being generated are, you know, definitely usable. And so that is how we do that. Now, for anyone who is brand new to Webflow and kind of wants to see how you can customize things pretty fast without needing to get overly technical, in Webflow, there'll be a variables panel, and all of the styles that were created for you during the AI site building process will be in here. So under design systems, just click on base collection and you'll see that all of your colors that were created have been added. You'll be able to see which variables are being used for your primary background. You'll be able to see, you know, the different text colors that are being used. And so ultimately, if you did want to come in and like customize things, you can do that straight from in here. It's a massive shortcut. And then also, you know, if you want to change fonts, super easy, just come in, change your font to whatever it is that you want. So let's change our heading font from Bevis Nair to Oswald. And then when you return to your site, it will pretty much update it all for you. So you can see here how my font has been updated. Okay, so far, pretty impressive. Obviously, you know, this here, I think, is going to be a dream for people who are brand new to this, or brand new to building websites. Let's have a look at how creating new pages will work, because obviously we might want to add a contact page. So what we'll do is we'll click on create a new page, and then you get the option to generate a new page with AI. And so what I want to do is I want to create a contact page. And so once again, this here is a massive shortcut. Now, I do think that there are a few things here. This is obviously something that will help non-designers build, but obviously if you're a designer or you've been using Webflow for years, you can still use this as a starting point in order to get your site up and running. So here's what was generated. Again, you know, there are always going to be some minor issues, for example, some images not being generated and all those kind of things. But if you know your way around Webflow, you'll know exactly how to find images so you can kind of fix things that are going on your site. And so ultimately, you know, considering that this has only been out for what, like 45 minutes, maybe a little bit more, it's actually super impressive. Now, I'm not sure if I've missed anything because I haven't been able to like dive into the weeds of it too much, but this is kind of just my first impression of using these tools. Maybe just a quick note, there's also a new themes section in the design panel, or not even the design panel, this panel over here. And so if you wanted to change things or customize your variables, kind of going back to the starting point of using the AI site builder, you can do that directly from in here. You know, even if you wanted to, you know, change, you know, some of the imagery and variables, all kind of straightforward to be done out of the bat. So I'm going to leave it here. This was really just my first look into how this tool works. I'd love to hear what everyone thinks about this. I'd love to hear from people who might already be building sites in Webflow. I'd love to hear what designers have to think about, what designers think about it. I'd love to hear what people who maybe like trying out different AI coding tools think, how this stacks up compared to that. But with that being said, I'm going to leave it here. Thanks so much for watching the video, and I'll see you back for the next one. Bye.